who hear ethnic slurs, they don't appreciate, but I loved them since years ago. They wanted to see us off the streets, say real soon we're gonna fade out, a fad. But soon they recognized this cultured epidemic as not just an urban addiction when it hooked everyone bad. They switched it to rural sickness, tried to close them off from BET and sending them to VH1 rehab. See, there's no cure once they're strung out on it. They'll never understand. It used to be all rock. Now MTV is exposed, spoken word on HBO. So I turn my radio on to call my doc. He's always there when I need him. From here on in, he supports a poet's love when I'm feeling. And without me, he lacks. Cause when I give him my love, he lyrically gotta spend time to flip it back. The rapper and the poet, baby, it's like a crack fiend and pusher man. We need each other to feel each other. His bold barks of remarks are my subtle hints as I print. The written world as I see it creates his words of music. I listen to him till I cop. He's standing there at the corner every day inspiring his writer to be raw. I sniff and I cough. I'm impatient, cooking up dope thoughts with the fire of strife. See, I wasn't born with a silver spoon, so my mind soaked up hard times like a cotton swab and my soul extracted from it like the needle of life. I hear him in the background now coaxing me, edging me on. You see, every feeling from my heart injected onto paper causes me a moment of peace. I pause. No pain, no joy, my mind elevated in awe. Inside, I see a light. There's no other words. I'm drifting. Then, I begin to write.
All I need is one mic. That's all I need. All I need is one mic.
Can I get that ghetto feel? Is y'all ready for LJ the poet? Y'all ready for LJ the poet? Let me hear you say, ah, yeah. Say, ah, yeah. Say, ah, yeah. Yeah.
When I look at you, all I do is laugh. I laugh because you're nothing but a joke and you're despised for everything you make me have to go through in order for me to have to prove myself. See, you're nothing but a common comment like the kind of hearts of these unsuspecting yet beautiful creatures that go by the name of woman. Take their hearts and their emotions and place them in your hand like a Nintendo Wii controller because you got the two very things to control the essence of them. You feel them these bogus lies and sequel stories like the name of George Bush only put at the bottom of the end, your words don't mean spit. But it doesn't matter to you, you know why? Because you're a player. A person that continually plays the game and win by any means necessary to get by. Using the pleasure and the property, what rests between women's thighs, and I ask myself, why? How can you do something that someone so elegant, betray the sincerity and trust bestowed upon you to even begin with? That's right, because you're a player. The jack of all trades, Mr. Mike Lowry, King Dingling. But after sitting back and watching your actions and analyzing you, finally came with the concept of why you act the way you do.
Why?
Because you're afraid to commit. Commit to only one and one thing in this world. Pathetic piece of a man you are. Better yet, you're not even a man at all. You're that sticky green fungus that grows on mushrooms when they begin to vegetate. See, let me give you a little insight about who I am. I'm the last of a dying breed. About as rare as you go and see if you can go to a court and spot a unicorn in this day and age. I'm what they like to call a good man. A man that stays faithful to only one and one woman. So when I say these things, you turn your back and roll your eyes all you want. But my actions alone make you like that kid on a small hill bus and stick his tongue out on the window. So you players that's going through life and wondering what's missing, just know that it's real women and that's why they get all my attention. While you sit back and wonder how you gonna get through December, just know that I got a woman that's coming to these warm loving arms to keep her warm in the winter. That's why I cook for my woman, clean for my woman,
hey,
clean
out,
love for my woman. Real women, laugh at your sorry nine because you have to strip from 99 cents to get them something from the value meal. Too late to clean it after yourself, so you still send your parents at the age of 27.
Preach.
And word on the street is, you have sex with your ladies, it's like a microwave. You just get all heated up and then you go ding it.
No!
Think yourself in early grade with these continual sexual escapades. Soon, you'll get clapped from something inside people's hands, or you're going to end up dying a lonely fool. You lonely now is only the point of telling you a story you already know. So you might as well get yourself together. go to the Social Security office, have them change your name to A Sexual, because the only thing you sexy is yourself.
Whoa!
But it's cool. So while you sit at home wondering why you slowly dying inside, just know that I'm happy and I'm glad to be off the market to know I'm in the arms of a woman that knows she has a faithful man. Now if you excuse me, I have to go home and cook dinner for my wife if you could. Please finish bagging my groceries.
All I need is one mic.
Alright, next time I'm gonna break this tape, we're gonna have to go all the way out because he was the third name on the list. And I told y'all earlier I'm just trying to get out of school system, so I skipped it. That's my bad, it's my public apology. So we all snap y'all fingers, let these guys go all the way down, please.
Torn three ways like hands on a clock, I don't know which way to go. Should I follow my own or should I follow some others? I am lost in the grooves of this brick pattern of my mind, misled by some beam shining through my own darkness. By choice, I am seen but not understood like braille to a seeing man. Yet no path has been shown, yet I press forward hoping to make it out. I build myself upon the love you have for me. Although not possible, as time goes by, my heart physically grows for you. I hate it when you're away. Although that may sound silly, it's true. You fill my heart with so much love and joy that it overflows into my spirit and makes my soul sing. When I think of you, I exhale. You illuminate my life. Angels cry tears of joy when your name is spoken. If I could rename you, I would name you. I smile and laugh because you make me so happy. You're the truth. Yes, I love you.
Neglected. Though there was only lust, it was love she detected in his touch. She just needed to be
felt, needed to be held with intensity, needed to feel like, for once, someone needed her immensely, even if only for her body, she needed to be needed. For every girl that believed him when he told her not to worry, even though it didn't matter the context of his story, she just wanted those right now words, needed that right now cure for emotional sickness, no matter how twisted the remedy. And for a second, when her body began to shake and he began to utter panting words, she saw the faintest glow of light. If only for the second, this is for the girl who fights just for that. For the girl who has morals, but she also has feelings, and when the man on top of her releases, she momentarily forgets that her heart is in pieces, and what she needs is not this. You are beautiful. For every girl who used sex as a cure for her hurt, injecting lies from too many men when she felt like dirt on the inside. But most days, all she really wanted to do was cry. Because when it was all said and done, when she looked to see how far she'd come, she hasn't gotten anywhere. In fact, sometimes it's like she's taken a few steps back because it hurts worse after realizing that love does not overcome emotion, nor can it be substituted for the devotion that she's looking for. You are beautiful. For every girl that realized that sex wasn't going to cure her pain, but did it anyway because the few minutes of pleasure were priceless. And when she started to slip back into that coma-like state, she resorted right back to her vices again and again, sin after sin, but stopping doesn't seem like an option. She doesn't want to face what's really happening, so she just moans as he feeds on her in between, and she releases too. And minutes afterwards, there's not much left to do but lie there and think about the hurt she was trying to run away from in the first place. For her sake, I'm writing this, and hope that she wants to continue to dismiss the reality of a love gone wrong, so that she will stay strong when she really needs to, and this is what I tell her to get through. You are beautiful, inside, outside. As hard as it is to believe right now, eventually the pain you feel will subside. This is for the girl who continues to give herself that same advice and then doesn't follow it. For every girl who wanted him to say, I love you, even if it wasn't true. Even if it was mid-stroke and said between heavy breathing and barely audible. So to every girl who's ever substituted love for temporary ecstasy, this is for you. And unfortunately, this is for me.
All I need is one mic. That's all I need. All I need is one mic.
Two eyes, yogi with two eyes, turning ink into inspiration, ignorance into intelligence. All right. Okay, I'm just because you. Intentions are for us to go from slow dancing to laying out smooth grunts and grooves. Moving lips to snail pops. Showing affection through bass drops. And hands travel skin covered in sweet scales. Right. Where the sax invites the eat, wanting to his own the egg. But jazz and appears and says, we're gonna do this a different way. Hands that normally rush now linger to the pace of the music. Can't lose it. The emotion evoked by rhythm as hands sway. And our mouths intertwine the same way the music does. In perfect harmony. See, I'm inviting you to the beat of me. That creates love that we hear, feel, and see. You're invited to jazz with me. Thank you.
be? Where shall I be? Will I be happy or sad? Will I be with the one I truly love? Will he truly love me? As I sit and I gather my thoughts, all that I can think is, will I be happy with my life? Shall I be strong in my faith? Will my husband be who or what I thought he should be? Will he be my Adam and I his Eve? Will we grow strong with the Lord and what we believe? Times have changed as well as the world we live. I look back at the times have passed. We have come a long way, but we have so much further to go. The slave days have passed, but there are still many who remain to stay in the past. What the Negro people should do is grow up, get a real life, and stop dwelling in the past. At this day and time, the thing that should be done is everyone join hands in unity. To become strong hand in hand, I sit and I wonder, what would it be like when my beautiful daughter becomes my age and older? Will she make the same mistakes as me and my mother before me? I pray not to this very day. I hope she will stay as pure as the day I brought her into this world. As God would say, all you have to do is pray unto thee, and he should bless you endlessly.
All I need is one mic. That's all I need. All I need is one mic.
Yeah. I'm gonna call a workhorse up here right now. Somebody said Riley was in the building. I don't know if it's Riley or Durham. Somebody said Durham was in the building. You don't want to cut that up. You'll make sure you get that right. You know what? These days get busy. They get way down the crazy fly old 45. Not no CD, not no CD these days. I'm about to be way down the crazy pull out old 45. Can I get that cat on camera? So I'm excited. My first time.
I know that's right.
First time.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
So tonight, you know, this month is Women's Month. Tonight's show is dedicated to her story. So this piece is basically checking for her story. If heartache was a language, you'd be fluent. If silence was the way you communicate, to speak. If I could feel every emotion, then maybe this empty feeling wouldn't be so hard. If I could give breath to life, then maybe my soul wouldn't be so fragmented. If I could see into the future, I would hide you from the future hurt of love. I would sidestep chance meetings and insert goodbyes for hellos. I would patch the holes of present love, using my soul as the asphalt and say it's my fault. I would cut out the heartache from my body, insert your smile, because this is strength needed for the new beginnings. I would trim the issues from problems. Remove the bitterness. Offer you some grade A love that only served my heart for dinner. I will leave you little small pieces of sugary heart stand when I love you. All over the place so you can have pieces of me everywhere. I would give you each vial of my heart so we can finally say our hearts beat as one. I will clean out the colored emotions of my heart so there can only be a space occupied solely for you. If I could, I would go back to creation. I would make you Eve and me Adam, so we be the first and only love. I'll erase premeditated murder like abortion and just meditate. I would love every child that's still born to a mother of unwed fathers. I'd become a seed. I'll become pregnant with your seed so I can see what it felt like to work in nature. Woo! I would do handstands and layouts so you have steps to a better tomorrow. I would confront every man or woman that's ever hurt you. Offer them a seat, a needle and thread so they can sow the seeds and sow your life and mend your heart back together. I would tell her story as if her story was my story. And let every woman, man, boy, and girl relive her story as if this was an open book ceremony. If I could, I would reach back into the past and become George Washington called me to my life.
Boy, stop.
I will become cough syrup so you can feel better with every dose. I will become a pain reliever so the only pain you will feel will be the pain of windows through sun rays. I will step in front of every no-name bullet so you never have to call out your son's name. I will lose weight so I can carry all of your burdens. I will exercise 365 so I can actually fit into your life. I would say I miss you for anniversary anything. I would tell you there's more to love than just making it. I would write a love book. I would write a poem to you, healing all the pain. Massaging the hurts, covering the bruises left from words, blocking the unwanted love taps, tying knots of lonely days and separated evenings. I would surgically implant the letters you and I into both of our palms so when we touch it's just you and I. I would fold myself into paper and drip apologies for every rape, every beating, and every molestation suffered at the hands of our forefathers. I will go back and rewrite history, changing the IS for ER and tell America's truly her story.
All right.
This is our story, my story, the story that we live every day, unfathomable and undiluted. This is her story.
All I need is one mic. All I need is one mic. That's all I need. All I need is one mic.
Next brother will bring the stage, Riley and Durham. Which one? Now we'll bring Riley to the stage. That was Durham. Now I'm gonna bring, I hope y'all ready, you know what I'm saying? The brother I'm gonna bring to the stage, published books, jumped in and out of slams, he sing, write, eloquent brother, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I like to tip my brother real cool. So, he one of the few people that embraced me when I came up. I was a squirt, you know what I'm saying? I'm still a squirt out of this catalog right here, so. I want y'all to do this right. Get bring that up. Just freestyle. Well, I should say style for you.
What's the name of your company anyway?
Mopic.
Mopic? Mopac?
Mopic.
Mopic?
Mopic.
Mopic Studios.